Hello everyone, this is Ansh from Bitten Tech, and in this video we are going to talk about a server side vulnerability known as buffer overflow. We will see how it works and its consequences. So let's get started. Before going to the vulnerability, let's first try to know what is a buffer. A buffer is a small memory allocation used when a program or a process is executed. Or you can say that a buffer is a small memory allocated for a specific input. It is stored on the system of the server of the website. If you are a programmer, you very well know that a certain amount of memory is allocated for every code you write. You need to take care of the memory before you write any program. So a buffer is a small memory size, specific memory size allocated for every input you take in your program. Now consider a situation. Suppose you are filling a form on a website or trying to log in, and there is a username field in which you need to enter your username. Now, if the maximum characters allowed for the username is 20, and you enter something longer than 20 characters, you give an input more than the buffer can hold, then the program must raise an error because the buffer only knows that 20 bits are to be allocated for the username. Then the program must raise an error if it is written correctly. It should prompt the user to enter less than or equal to 20 characters. But if the program is not written correctly, it will not show any error. In fact, it will take the extra input and process it. And it will put the extra input adjacent to the actual buffer and take it in the memory. In other words, the buffer size will get overflowed and the extra input will also be processed. This is the vulnerability. This is called buffer overflow. So buffer overflow is a condition when a program writes more data to the memory than it is actually supposed to take. Now you will ask me what will happen to the extra input which went into the overflown buffer. What if the input contains any shell command or a malicious script or a virus command? Yes, it will go to the system itself and get executed. Once a script is executed on a system, the attacker can easily get access to the system. He can send a command to download the database, or drop the tables, or delete files, and so on. Also, due to overflow of input, the system may get crashed and ultimately go down. To summarize, he can challenge the integrity of the server or system. This vulnerability is exploited to target web applications, programs, and servers. Buffer overflow is an example of bad programming. This vulnerability is caused by newbies who are new to programming and leave such conditions which don't raise any error. It is generally seen in C and C++ languages. New languages like C#, Java, Perl have somewhat reduced this vulnerability. So this was a basic overview of buffer overflow. If you want a practical on this, do let me know in the comment section below. So that's it for today. If you learned something from this video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more videos on cybersecurity and technology. Until next video, stay tuned, keep watching, and goodbye.